Well, for more analysis, we can speak now to Leslie Piquemal, who is an advocacy director at the Cairo Institute for Human Rights Studies, who joins us now from Brussels. Thank you so much for speaking to us. What is your understanding, first of all, as to why these protests are taking place?
Well, these protests are a continuation of the wave of demonstrations that occurred last weekend in response to many Egyptian citizens' anger, frustration, exasperation, and sense of injustice at the economic conditions and social conditions they're experiencing, which were already really harsh, but have been deteriorating further since 2015. And in that context, the news of credible allegations of massive corruption on the part of President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi and his close military advisors, the top of the military hierarchy, was basically the spark that triggered the expression of this anger. And people began to demonstrate last weekend in several waves and in several cities across the country. Then a massive wave of crackdown throughout the week responded to that. And today, they came out again in an attempt to protest in several locations, but were met again with a very, very strong wave of repression.
Yeah, I mean, street demonstrations have almost been completely silenced, haven't they, ever since President Sisi took office. And that means that people taking part in these protests are risking a huge amount, aren't they?
They are indeed. It ranges from forced disappearance and torture, very long arbitrary detention. You can also face gunfire from security forces, rubber bullets, live rounds. You can lose your life in a protest. You can also effectively lose the rest of your livelihood if you are detained and prosecuted on a political basis for having exercised your right to freedom of expression and peaceful assembly. There are often terrorism-related charges brought against people detained for peacefully protesting, and they can spend years and years and years in jail in terrible conditions.
Yeah, I mean, there's been a very serious clampdown, hasn't there, on people who protest. You mentioned that. I mean, some 2,000 people have been arrested since the protests began. I mean, what do we know about the whereabouts of all of those people who've been detained and what sort of conditions they've had to endure?
Information is sadly patchy, as we know. What we do know is that over 2,000 people have been detained in the past 6 days. Human rights lawyers on the ground have been struggling to document all of these cases. So the over 2,000 figure only represents the cases we have knowledge of. Several hundred have also been forcibly disappeared. The persons detained appeared little by little before the state security prosecution, again with these terrorism-related charges. And many of the people detained actually since last Friday, the 20th, are still in the system, meaning we don't know exactly where they are. But it is known that several hundred were sent to illegal places of detention, in particular the barracks of the Central Security Forces, the Egyptian Riot Police, which are not should not be used, legally speaking, to hold prisoners.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it there. I'm so sorry to cut you off. Leslie Piquemal, Advocacy Director at the Cairo Institute for Human Rights Studies, thank you very much indeed for sharing that with us.